Hey yo together and very welcome back to the next entry into the StarCraft 2 diary on this very hot Tuesday. Unfortunately, I missed to press the record button for my voice, so I have to rethink the whole episode again. I'm really sorry for it. I will do my best. And yeah, what we are doing in this episode is trying to grab all watchtowers. Try to get our upgrades earlier, which means trying to get Stim before the 10-minute mark, the combat shield before the 10-minute mark. Also, don't neglect our units production and the SCV production. We want as well get our CCs into orbital commands. What else could we want to do in this episode? I think that's it. Getting the upgrades earlier is quite important. Going the expansion earlier is quite important. I mean, we grab our expansion now way earlier than in the first episode of the StarCraft 2 diary, indeed, but there is still room for improvement. And I was talking so much, I don't know what I should say now. I mean, the last enemy was a gold player. I guess he was a gold player, I'm not quite sure. But what we were able to see is that if you are macroing well, getting up your expansions up and running and produce units all the time, never be supply blocked, then you can crush almost every enemy. I mean, at least from bronze to, yeah, let's say platinum. So we should also start soon with the 1v1 ranked game. I hope we do. Also, I wanna say, if you have some ideas or critics or anything you want to say to me, just spit it out. I will try my best to make the StarCraft Diary as entertaining, as most entertaining as this is, which means also I try to improve my voice and my pronunciation, the way I talk, if I'm grabbing for words I don't know, stuff like that. Also, if the video and audio quality is bad, let it me know. I think it should be okay. And it seems that we are pretending to play now. Come on, Alex. It's really crazy how long I was talking. I don't remember every word and phrase and whatever it was I was talking so much about before starting the game. Come on! I'm talking so. There we go, finally! Really awful. Really, really terrible. I thought I would never ever forget to push this record button again, but it happened again to me. I had a really tough day. Yeah, was quite stressing. It is a TVT on Whirlwind against Naga with the Widowmine as his avatar. So what you should know is that this map is never cross-position. I mean, it can be cross-position, but it isn't cross-position only. So I can halfway show you this. I mean, I can't use my mouse now because it is already recorded. But if you are spawning in the left bottom corner, the enemy isn't always in the right upper corner. So there we go, GLHF. I used again the S button for the SCV, I'm sorry about that. But you can also use the hotkeys on your keyboard. Later on you will always have the right hand, or the hand you are playing with, on the mouse, and the other hand, which is the left hand by myself, on the keyboard to press all the hotkeys. So for now we are not going for anything special, just get our SCVs is the new mixture of SCV and Marines, yeah, the SCVs. We're going to produce more SCVs and then get our supply depot. There we go. And back to work after constructing the supply depot. So as I told you, we want to get the watchtower in this game. And anything else, the upgrades way earlier. So we are A little bit supply cap. So we should get our barracks up now. There we go. There's our barracks. And never neglect your SCVs. You should always constantly produce SCVs until the 5 minute mark, 10 minute mark, I don't know, I'm not sure. But in the early stage of the game, you should always produce your SCVs quite constantly. So now we are going to scout and see his SCVs. So what we are going to do is put our SCVs on the attack command onto his SCV, so we can prevent him from building any sneaky stuff, things like proxy barracks or a proxy bunker, to prevent us expanding. For now we are going to get a second barracks and a second supply depot, get our SCV on, our marine on the way. Normally we would get the supply depot with by the 15 supply mark. Now we are grabbing our orbital command, and as you can see he's going on a command center first, which means if he is on 14 supply he will throw down a CC. And now I have a fancy idea. We grab this SCV who was attacking another SCV, the scouting SCV, and we are building a bunker right there. The reason for this is he wants to expand, and with this bunker we can prevent him, we can contain him a little bit, we can put pressure on him. And as he was going for a CC first, he wants the advantage of an early expansion. What we should do now is also get our expansion up as soon as possible. I'm failing a little bit because I am going to set up this contain, but soon I should get our expansion by my own. So we are still producing more marines, trying not to get supply cap. Then we are looking up there, what he is doing. He's going for a CC, and then for he's going for the orbital command. So we set up the rally point up, and now we are going to expand. And what we should do now is to keep him 100 seconds away from this location, because then our expansion is finished and his is still not up. So let's get the marines into this bunker. Right click on the repair button, so the SCV will auto repair this bunker and deal some damage with those marines, just to show him that he can't expand there. He could expand, of course, on the location where normally his third expansion would be, his third base would be, but it's most unlikely. We are getting an SCV there soon. But for now we are just getting the add-ons and the eBay for the upgrades, the second refinery. Yeah, and our expansion is on the way as well, while his isn't. This is the advantage we are now going onto, and yeah, there we go with the second refinery. There is the scouting marine. Now we should get Stim and train some units. We are on 35 to 43 supply, so we should get a supply depot soon. For now we are going to produce a bunker just for a little bit safety if he can crush the contain. What he normally should do is now getting a foreign drop, banshees or tanks. Nothing is coming, so I wanna scout, but not with the SCV. We need the SCV to repair the bunker, so we are getting a marine up there, and we see two bunkers, which means he is containing himself. And now we are immediately grabbing a third base. Because of this, he wants to be contained, he wants to throw away his advantage, and now we are going and grab our chance to be greedy, more greedy than he was. So Stim is on the way, units are on the way, still just with two barracks. But we should be able to get some new production facilities soon. Like now a factory and I think two barracks as well. Yeah, there we go. Because with three bases we can afford it. We could also throw down three more barracks. But we want to have some upgrades, and we will we want also to get the supply depots and more SCVs and not to overcommit. Because if he now is crushing one of those expansions with a drop, for example, then we have the production facilities and can't use them because we lack an income. Now he's crushing this, but look at it. He has still no combat shield. He attacked not the SCV, so he lost so many marines to a bunker, an SCV, and like four more marines. He lost almost his entire army, while we have our backup home, are getting the tech lab for tanks, another star, let's get a starport for the medivacs, because medivacs can heal up your biofuel so strong. So there we are going for a second factory, double tank production. Those buildings are a little bit misplaced, so the tank couldn't get out. A tank of the lower factory. So we are going to get the orbital command and the add-ons as well. I mean, it's a lot you have to bear in mind. You have always to throw down the mules and to produce stuff. But for now we are fine. We have almost four refineries, which means we can get the tech we are going to. The double tank production and the double medivac production. There's the reactor for the double medivac production. We have still no combat shields, but they are on the way. A little bit too late. But now we are going on the concussive shells. Not enough gas for the gas for the for the plus one armor. Then we saturate the refinery. He is now expanding and doing the same thing as we do, but with, I think, a lower income. So he has less production facilities, less upgrades, less workers. He is behind in almost everything. Because he wanted to play greedy and then turned around into his, oh, I don't feel safe, I need bunkers. We would never go there and attack. On the minimap, we see that he is going to expand now. He will kill this SCV, but we have the scouting information and we can delay it a little bit, like 20 seconds or so. Normally, we want to grab the watchtower. We now grabbed way earlier, but in this game, it's not close position, so he will unlikely attack through the middle. We are also almost supply cap, so throw down two emergency cooldowns. And scan what he has. The scan was quite misplaced. We don't see his army or his production facilities. But okay, let's just get more SCVs, more units, more tanks, and more supply depots, because we will need them. With the production facilities we have, we need them. We really will need them. So what I also can tell you is you can, with the shift command, tell units to use the ability after a specific waypoint. Means you A click on a location, and if they reach the location there, then the siege tank siege, for example. Or then the marines are stimming and attacking. So waypoints are quite useful. Also, you can use the waypoint command for the abilities. There's the scan, we see that he is grabbing more stuff, but still no army. And there we go, we see no no combat shields and no tanks, no tanks. This is the reason why we are now going to attack. I attempted to get the marines also out of the bunker, but nah. With the tab command, you have on the keyboard the tabulator button, you can switch through your units. You have selected, so we are double tabbing for selecting the tanks, and then we can siege them. Those medics flew a little bit too wide, too far, but it's okay because of the waypoints. We can see, oh, we should siege here. He has so many marines, but no combat shields. He is using so much, look at it. And we have the medics. He has also medics. And medics, without medics, it would have been way worse for us. Because medics, if you have medics, the bioforce you have is double as strong as without. So we are able to crush this expansion. Down it goes. Quite closely, but this is so huge. He lost an expansion. And now he can't use all the production facilities he has. He has, I don't know, lots of barracks, lots of stuff. And still, there you go, still no combat shields, still no tanks. This is the reason, this is one example for bad macro. He don't have his upgrades, he isn't spending his money well, we are sieging up the tanks, and we can crush this wall easily. We missed our rally point on this factory, but it's okay. Not big deal, we are getting the supply down, and we are so far ahead, he will never catch up to us again. One thing I want to tell you is, normally this force you can see now, with the rally points on one unit in the front, they would go there, and normally you can do this, but against a Terran, if he is going for drops, and your army is, all your army is on the front, then you haven't anything back at home to protect, so versus Terran, you're most likely not setting the rally points to your army at the front. I know splitting your army is bad, but if you're setting up a contain, the enemy will most likely try to bust out with drops, and then you need your army, a part of your army back home. He has now the combat shield. He's crushing this army, but our reinforcement, oh look at it. No chance, no chance. And now we can easily go there. That's it, no GG, as usually. And that's it, I mean, he had 1-1 while we were on 0-1. But with the tanks, and we had so much more units, he was on pure marines. Never stick to just one unit type, never do this. Mix in some other troops, Banshees or Hellbats or tanks, tank marine and some marauder and medics is so strong in the lower leagues. I mean, it is also strong in the higher leagues, but they know how to break a contain. Yeah, I'm talking now a little bit about the first CC, the CC first, and how we contained him with the bunker while we are getting our first and second expansion on the way because of his bunker. Really, normally, if the thing we were doing with the bunker, with the proxy bunker, to block his expansion, we would never go up the ramp and attack, because he will have the defender's bonus, which means we have to run up the ramp before we can see something. He has the production facilities back at home, so reinforcements will arrive way earlier, he can repair the buildings, and most likely we would just throw away our units. So throwing down bunkers in this situation was just the wrongest, the most wrongest move. I know there is no increasement of wrongest, I know this, but it was really so bad that it was just the wrongest move you could have ever done. It would have been better if he grabbed all his units, even the SCVs, and bust out instead of bunker himself into his main. No, don't do this. Normally, you then, if you see this, you wanna get as. Yeah. You could get lots of units so you can crush it, or tanks, or Banshees, or Medivacs, then you can drop yourself out of the contain.
Mineral field depleted.
And just these bunkers, really, they are freaking me out. They are so useless, it doesn't make any sense. And this is also a key part of the game. You have to know what you are doing and why you are doing it. I guess he was feeling unsafe and thought it is an attack. I would attack soon, but this refers to his missing scouting information. He didn't know nothing about us. Nothing. I mean, he had the scouting SCV, and he knew that we were not going on CC first, but that's it. He never scouted our base. I mean, he throw down once, a scan, but nothing special. And as you saw now, he had so many production facilities, but out of two bases with the upgrades, he can't produce all the time. Unfortunately, I am still talking and showing you stuff with those production facilities. You can see up this ramp, he was trying to get an expansion up as we crushed his third. But it was way too late, he should have needed Banshees or tanks. Tanks would have been nice, really nice. He needed tanks. Or more units than we had. or better upgrades, or to drop on our tanks, something like that, but straight up, with an unupgraded Bioforce, with the lack of combat shields, never ran into a tank line, never, with Marines. They got almost one shot and will die with dealing no damage. I personally think we did better than the last games. The upgrades we were getting were not so good, but it was okay. And yeah, the watchtower, it wasn't crucial that we hadn't grabbed the watchtower, but we should have. We really should have. Alright, but we won this game. I'm sorry for my bad English and the and that I missed the to press the record button. I hope you enjoyed. I wish you a nice day and goodbye.